President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. joins the clamor for an investigation into the questionable background of Banban Tarlac Mayor Alice Guo. Ara Perez reports.
No less than President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. believes Banban Tarlac Mayor Alice Guo must be investigated, saying she is now known among local leaders.
Kilala ko lahat ng mga tiga-Tarlac na politiko eh. Walang may kilala sa kanya. Saan nanggaling ito? Bakit ganito ito? Hindi namin malaman. Kaya kailangan talagang imbestigahan. So kasabay ng sa Bureau of Immigration, pati siguro may mag-question na ng kanyang citizenship. Yun, lahat, iimbestigahan natin yun. Kasama ang imbestigasyon ng mga hearing na ginagawa ng Senado.
Guo was first thrust into the spotlight after being linked to a Philippine offshore gaming operator recently raided by authorities. That Pogo company was located just behind the Municipal Hall of Bamban. Senator Rizzo Ontiveros then zeroed in on Guo's personal background after receiving reports that the mayor came out of nowhere in last 2022 elections. Solicitor General Minardo Guevara has created a special team to look into the matter and determine if there is good reason to believe that Guo is unlawfully holding public office. Guevara adds, the OSG is currently gathering relevant information from the Commission on Elections, Bureau of Immigration, and other government agencies. The COMELEC meanwhile defends its decision to accept Guo's Certificate of Candidacy.
Una po, nung nag-file po ng application for registration as voter po si Mayor Guo sometime in 2018, ay lumalabas po na wala pong nag-oppose sa kanyang application for registration. Ganon din po ang nangyari nung siya po ay tumakbo, nagsumite ng Certificate of Candidacy nung 2021. Wala pong natanggap ang COMELEC na either na petition for cancel or deny due course the COC kung meron mang material misrepresentation mismo doon sa Certificate of Candidacy, at wala rin pong natanggap ang COMELEC na petition for disqualification.
The COMELEC says Guo can face charges for providing false information in her COC if it is proven that she is not a Filipino citizen. An election law professor meanwhile says possible cases against Guo should be filed before regional trial courts.
Ano pwedeng kaso after mo maproklama? Katulad ngayon, no? Ang isang nga is yung tinatawag natin co-warranto, pero dahil municipal official siya, ang may jurisdiction hindi COMELEC, ang may jurisdiction regional trial court. Dalawang isang kaso, yung tinatawag na perjury, dahil kung nagsinungaling siya sa kanyang certificate of candidacy. Pero hindi yan COMELEC. Ang sampa mo ng kaso sa prosecutor's office, tapos ang trial niyan sa regional trial court.
Some residents meanwhile assert Guo has been a long-time resident of Bamban.
Sa pagkakaalam ko po, mismong magkatibay kami niyan eh. Since 2005, siguro mga nasa delegitan niya si Mama Liz, nakita ko na yan. Tapos nung 2008, nakakausap ko na yan dahil tagawad na ako noon, may poultry sa dyan.
ABS-CBN News has been trying to get Guo's side for days now, but she has yet to make a public appearance. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine president vowing to fend off any destabilization attempt, Marcos says his administration will not allow agents within the country to destabilize the government and create division. He spoke at a military camp in Cagayan de Oro, where he urged soldiers to also fight disinformation and digital operations that seek to sow conflict. The president warns of possible attempts by the country's enemies to infiltrate Philippine communities and institutions.